H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Hi everyone, this is Rama, Selenium training instructor. Good evening, thank you for joining QA Automation Selenium training demo today. We will officially start the QA demo in 1 or 2 minutes. Before we start the demo, please let me know if anyone has any questions. Right now you should be able to see the desktop and also you should be able to hear me. Please let me know if you have any issues. And also, if you have any questions before we officially start the demo, please let me know. Great. So agenda for today is, this is a Selenium training demo. This week or early next week, our student coordinator will let you know the next official first class for Selenium training. In the meantime, at the end of this demo, we will send you the recording. And before you come for the first class, I will share my again, full name, the email ID and phone number. If you have any questions, training related, which is Selenium related, you can reach me out. But the fee details and other stuff, you can reach out to the student coordinator directly. So that is the plan. So one thing I can say, H2K Infosys is there in the business, training and placement business, in so many years. So far we have trained almost 50,000 students. The success rate was very high. A lot of students, they got the placements or a job in QA field after their successful completion of their training. They are working at big companies, mid-level companies and startup companies as well. We are there to help you during the training. When you are preparing for the interviews, we are there. Once you get a job at client's place, if you have any concerns, questions and all, we are there to help. Our goal is to provide successful hands-on training in Selenium. And then we want to even provide the placement assistance. So another good thing is, one thing I just explained, H2K Infosys. The next thing, the reason you need to take training from us is, one is because of H2K Infosys background, what they did so far, especially in a training point of view, placement point of view. Second thing is about me. So there is introduction slide about myself, we can go through it. But so myself, I'm in QA industry last 20 years. Last 18 years, I'm giving the Selenium automation plus even manual testing and other QA related trainings. I'm local to Dallas, Texas. I'm not only the instructor. I have my full-time job as a quality assurance automation manager. Teaching is my passion. So my first student was my wife. I trained her sometime 2002-03 time frame. She got a job. Then I started giving trainings outside. So another advantage is, whatever myself and my team members implementing and developing the automation at client's place, I'm exactly simulating the same during our training. It is a purely job oriented hands on training. Definitely by attending these my classes, you follow my instructions, there is no question of not getting the job. Everyone will get a job. That is the guarantee I can give. So we can start now. Some of them I already covered, so you can feel free and stop me and ask me any question if we have it. This is about our H2K Infosys. Our main office is located in Atlanta, but students attending throughout the world. So while attending online classes, these are the few instructions, but we are doing these online sessions and all with the trainings, our families and all we are doing. It is like a part of our life due to COVID and all. I don't need to specially explain anything about how to attend online classes and all. So this is the agenda that we are going to cover. Though the list is big, but you will enjoy learning all these agenda items. We'll go through it one by one. So about H2K Infosys, one thing I forgot, it's a e-verified company. E-verified, also I don't take much time, I'll quickly explain. After training is completed, when we are try to market your resume and all, some clients or some companies, they will take the automation engineers or the consultants only from the company who has e-verified. Okay, H2K Infosys already has a, it's a e-verified company. That is one of the good thing. And our clients, we already listed here, GE, AT&T, so and so. This is what we are doing. We are providing the training. We are even giving training for MS students. We are into software development, testing, and also providing placement assistance plus support. So other than along with the Selenium training, we are even offering the following courses. So today you're attending the demo for Selenium training. So before you come for next class, if you have any friends and all, please refer us and check with the student coordinator about referral discount. This is about myself. So 20 years I'm in QA, 18 plus years I'm giving trainings. 1900 plus students already took training both in class and online. I'm certified QA. I work for Cisco, eBay. The reason I mentioned this, I work for big company, mid-level company and startup company. So the work style is different, but most of the companies nowadays following the startup culture. So the entire Selenium training will go in agile process with a startup mode. That way you will learn better. Student introduction, we can pause this, but I will quickly read the name. So far we have Gigi, Neha, Sheila, Sindhu, and Shri. So we have five students attending this class, this demo, Selenium demo session. We'll skip this part for now. Okay. So this is a Selenium training demo. That means you're attending automation testing using Selenium. Once this course is completed, you will apply for automation testing jobs using Selenium. The prerequisites for automation testing, technically we have to say, in order to learn Selenium, you need to learn at least one programming language, let's say Java. But I'm going to teach Java as part of Selenium training. So I'm not considering that as a prerequisite. So for automation testing, the prerequisite is manual testing. So I'll take 1 or 2 minutes. First of all, we'll quickly discuss. Maybe some of you already know what is QA, manual testing and all. But even if one person doesn't know, it's my responsibility to explain. So QA stands for quality assurance. Our job is to test the application, which is a web-based application or client-server application or mobile application or tomorrow robots. Our job is to test and find the bugs. So you are searching for iPad, you are expecting iPad results. Instead of iPad results, if you are getting iPhone results, that's a bug. You are trying to log in to the application with valid credentials like valid username password. When you try to log in with valid username password, we should be able to log in, but login failed. That's a bug. So QA manual tester's job is to find the defects. Then developers will fix it. QA will test it again. If it is working, close it. Else, we'll reopen. Let developer fix it again. You test it and close it. So technically, manual testing we will do by using the hand. I will give one non-technical example. So in our house, in the kitchen, we have a sink and we have some vessels. If you are going to clean them, this is not my example. One of the students, after she completing manual testing and attended, she attended few automation classes. That time I used to teach QTP long back. Now most of the companies migrated to Selenium. She told one day, now I know the exact difference between Malin and automation. Whatever I'm going to tell, that is the same example she has given. I like that. That is the reason I wanted to give this example, non-technical example, the difference between manual and automation. If you clean the vessels with your hand, it's a manual testing. If you put the vessels into dishwasher and press the button, start button, it's an automation. So that is the difference between manual and automation testing. So now I'm not only showing the theory part. I will take one scenario. I will test that manually, how manual testers will do it. I already have one. I already created one Selenium automation script. We are not going to discuss each and every line of script that we created, but I will execute so that the tool will test that particular scenario. First of all, let's discuss theory part of what is the difference between manual testing and automation. So manual testing we will do with the hand, whereas automation testing, the tool will be taken care. Manual testing is always kind of time consuming process. Sometimes you may do mistakes, but automation is faster and it can give the results quickly so that we can release our products little ahead. So without automation and with automation, definitely companies will see a lot of difference. Initially, there is an investment for automation testing, but down the road, company will see a lot of benefits by introducing automation testing. So I will consider, just an example. We have Sheila and Sindhu. Sheila is a manual QA and Sindhu is automation QA. So go to google.com. So Sheila is a manual QA and let's say she is working for Google and she wants to check Google search is working or not with the different keywords. Example, QA. So if we search for QA and we are expecting the results for QA, there are many ways to validate. So I'm searching for QA, I need to see the QA results. Somewhere here, if we see QA, then we can say in the content area, if we see QA, then we can say, yes, we got the right results. The other way is if the title of the page is showing QA-Google search, then I got the right results. Then go back, this time maybe search for Java. I'm expecting the title of the page must be Java-Google search. Instead of Java-Google search, if we see something like Salesforce-Google search, that is incorrect. So manual tester, Sheila will mark it as a fail, that particular test, and she will submit a bug. So like that, she will try with the different keywords, whatever she planned to do it. If all the keywords giving the right results, then Sheila will mark search is working as expected. Otherwise, she will say it is not working as expected and she will submit a bug. So once manual tester, whatever we are discussing about manual versus automation, this is just maybe 1-5% only. This is just a demonstration. Officially, when we start our first automation class, that time everything will go in detail. And if somebody asks a question saying, I'm not from IT or computer science background, or I'm from computer science background or IT background, doesn't matter. Anyone can take this Selenium training. We will teach everything. All you need is you need laptop and internet connection. Remaining all training materials, softwares, everything we are going to provide. All you need to do is you need to attend 3 classes per week that we will discuss. So that's all. So we will completely take care. So you saw how we tested a particular test case or a particular scenario manually. So manual tester tested that. So generally, once manual tester complete the testing a particular scenario, then that will be given to automation team. But I will explain a little more. Give me a minute. So Google, we have search functionality. We have I'm feeling lucky, and we have about, we have store, we have Gmail, we have images. These are all so many features are available within google.com. Since we are following agile process, most of the companies, it is like a parallel development and testing. Right now I'm talking about manual testing. So developer will develop, let's say, this image and search button, that's all, and a Google search button, and remaining all won't be there. Just assume Google just started developing google.com. So one feature developer developed, it will be given to QA, manual QA. Manual QA will take maybe a couple of days to test it manually. By that time, manual testing, complete testing the first feature, example search, developer will give another feature, let's say, I'm feeling lucky, along with the first feature. Now, QA will test, manual QA will test the second feature as a new one. Once manual tester complete testing second feature, manual tester has to go back and test the previous feature, still working or not. Every time when developer adds the new feature, there may be a chance old feature may not work. So when QA go back and test the old feature, that is called regression testing. So manual tester will say, yes, I'm ready to test my old features on a different browser operating systems and all. But manual tester will ask more time to test the new features as well as testing the old features on Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10, 12. i.e. Firefox, Chrome, Safari, Mac. They will ask more time, or manual testers will ask more resource. But nowadays, there is a lot of competition. Companies don't want to wait for so many days to release their new features. That is the reason either they have to provide more manual QA engineers or introduce automation. Now, we introduced automation engineer, let's say Sindh is our automation person. Now let's go back and discuss the same scenario again. So we got developer has given the first feature, Google search. So manual tester will test it manually. By the time automation engineer will set up, like they will set up their test bed, installing Java, installing Eclipse, installing Selenium WebDriver, Selenium Grid, SVNR, GitHub, Jenkins, Maven, these are all things will be installed. So by the time manual tester complete testing the first feature and you assume there are no bugs, that particular feature will be given to automation team and automation engineer will automate that particular first test. So by the time manual tester complete testing the second feature and ready to test the world feature as part of regression, the script is ready. So instead of manual tester test that old feature manually, all they need to do is, this is what they will do. So whatever test, search for different keywords, QA, Selenium, etc. in google.com, right? That is the test manual tester did it. So now manual tester, all they need to do, this is the kind of code has been written. Manual tester, all she or he has to do is, Sindhu has created this automation Selenium script. Since she is an automation engineer, assume Sheila is a manual QA. So this script will be given to, Sindhu will give this script to Sheila. Technically, it will be in a version control tool. We'll discuss all these things. So they will know where it is located. All you need to do is, you will right click and run as Java application. This is one way of executing, but as part of our training, you're also going to learn continuous integration process using Jenkins. So Jenkins is like another, like a website. You will log in there, you will see all these scripts. You don't need to even see the code. All you need to do is just say run. As soon as you click run, the browser will be launched and it will verify whatever test cases have been automated. So this is the difference between manual testing versus automation testing. Okay. So if you have any question like, oh, there is a code, maybe first time I'm seeing, will I able to do it? Everyone will be able to write this kind of code. When you attend our classes, follow my instructions, definitely. So everything, we have a very good documentation. Example, this is the automation Selenium automation training documentation. Each and every step is documented. It's like a spoon feeding. Initially, you're going to learn Java for Selenium. Java for Selenium. After that, you're going to learn TestNG for Selenium. Then you will learn the actual tool called Selenium WebDriver. After that, you are even going to learn Selenium Grid. And finally, you're going to learn the automation framework. We'll discuss more about it. But please let me know anyone has any questions so far. So feel free, if others not asking, maybe they are shy, don't think they understand completely. So this is the right time for you to ask any questions. Please go ahead, Sri, please go ahead. We cannot hear you. Please unmute and talk. Sri, if you cannot talk, you can type there. Otherwise, please unmute and talk. That will be much faster. Yes, please go ahead. We cannot hear you so far. Yeah, your audio is unmuted, but still we cannot hear you. Are you talking? I didn't see any anything moving on your icon, audio icon. Okay, so I can take your question anytime once we start hearing your audio. So that is the difference between manual and automation testing. So this is very important slide. Please everyone quickly have a look. So this is the Selenium training curriculum. Total kind of 6 subjects you are going to learn within automation. Initially you are going to learn automation end-to-end process. This can be one of the interview questions. So when I hire automation engineers in my team, I'm the hiring manager too. One of my question is or was, please explain me the Selenium automation end-to-end process that you learned or you worked. That will tell whether you really took proper training or whether you really worked. So nowadays companies are looking for 2 type of people. One is either experienced people or well-trained people. So due to COVID, until last November, December, market was super good. We expected this and next year also. But due to COVID, though we have a lot of openings, if you take my company as an example, we already have some openings. But due to COVID, we did not release. COVID is kind of slowly going away. So we are slowly releasing. So by that time, this course is going to take 2 months. Maybe you need another 2 weeks to 4 weeks of time to get ready for the interviews and all. That means I'm expecting if you properly follow our guidance and everything, within 3 months, you must be in a job. So you need to utilize this time. Just follow us, attend all the classes. If you come late or even if you miss the session, don't worry. We are recording every class. We will share the class recording. So peacefully you can practice whatever we discussed on the next day. So automation, end-to-end process, we are going to discuss. And whatever number of classes and all we mentioned, this is, we need to have some numbers and hours. These are all approximate. Sometimes it may always go more. So we don't teach based on number of hours or number of classes. We want to teach our students whatever is really needed for them to clear the interviews and get the jobs. So don't calculate number of hours or number of classes. Our goal is to provide proper training and place you. Next, you're going to learn Java programming. So during this time, If you have some idea about Java, that is good. Even if you don't have anything, I will explain everything from scratch. What is Java? How to set up Eclipse is an editor to write the Java programming, and how to install Java. So this is going to take close to 5+ classes. You will learn it. So we are already here. We already did bachelor's or master's. We are already smart. We already learned English or social or science or math. Or arts, learning Java is not a big deal. Okay, definitely you will learn. So you may ask one question, which is, if I need to learn Java programming, I would have gone as a Java developer, why should I come for QA or Selenium? So if you are a Java developer, if there are 100 topics in Java programming, you need to learn minimum 70 to 80 of the 80 topics out of 100. But whereas when you go as an automation engineer using Selenium, maybe 20-30% of Java knowledge is good enough. So Selenium is not fully depending on Java. Selenium has its own commands. Okay, that is the reason you are learning Java. Then second thing is you're going to learn TestNG. TestNG, though it is saying automation framework, TestNG we are mainly using for generating a better reports when you write, see, we executed this program, right? And we saw the results, whether pass or fail and all. But these are all showing everything in a text format. But if you want to see all these things in a nicer nicer HTML format and all, let me show you. If you want to see your results in a nicer format like this, in HTML format, right? Pass or fail, what time it executed, how many times we executed, all these details. If it is fail, we'll get real information, more information, and also it will take screenshot. So all these things can be possible by having TestNG, and also by using TestNG, we are going to reduce a lot of duplication of code. For now, that is enough. You will get more info when we officially learn TestNG. Plus, TestNG is needed if you are going to use Selenium Grid. I will quickly explain what is Selenium Grid. So next, Selenium 3.0 WebDriver. This is the actual tool. This is the actual Selenium tool. Earlier we used to have Selenium IDE. Later they introduced Selenium RC, which is a remote control, which is Selenium 1.0. But IDE has some limitations, RC has some limitations. Later they introduced Selenium 2.0 WebDriver. Now latest version is 3.x WebDriver. So whatever limitations we have with the RC, these are all we could able to resolve it by upgrading to Selenium 3.0 WebDriver. So when we start Selenium WebDriver, I'm going to show how Selenium IDE works. The RC is not there anymore, but WebDriver. So I will explain the difference between IDE as well as WebDriver. But IDE we should not use, we should not even include in our resume. IDE is like record playback. The moment some companies they see IDE, they may think you're record playback kind of automation engineer. Okay, only to show, I will just show one Selenium IDE script. Maybe we'll spend maybe 10-15 minutes, that's all. You will keep it, when needed you will use it, otherwise 99% of your time during our training as well as when you join at client's place, you will always use Selenium WebDriver. So Selenium WebDriver, using Selenium WebDriver, that is what we automated, this one. So like that, we did Google search, right? At the same time, let's say Sindhu automated about another script, store, another script, Gmail, another script, images, another script, like that. Let's say we have five programs. Okay, we have five programs. One is search program, search script. Second one is about script. Third one is a Gmail script. Like that, we have five. With Selenium, we can execute all these five, let's say all these five scripts in a batch. But when you run them, it will only go in a sequential order. It will execute only one after other. Let's say if each script is going to take 10 minutes, we need to wait for, because we have five scripts, we need to wait for 50 minutes to complete the test execution. But whereas if we have Selenium Grid configured within your automation environment, Selenium Grid will let you execute the scripts in a parallel mode. That means all five will be executed at the same time. So Selenium Grid we are using mainly for parallel execution, and also we can execute all the scripts parallelly on a remote missions. The mission can be within your organization, it can be outside Texas, or it can be outside US, it can be anywhere in the world. If both the servers talking, we can execute the scripts remotely. So, but Selenium Grid requires TestNG. So that is one of the reason. So for TestNG, you're using one for better reporting purpose, second one is for to integrate with Selenium Grid. The 2.0.5 is the very important topic. Most of the places they are not teaching, they are just teaching the theory part, because teaching Selenium Automation Framework, anyone should able to teach only if they have the documentation. I took almost 2 years to prepare this documentation. This has almost 50 plus pages. Today or tomorrow, you can go to Indeed or Dice.com and search for Selenium with your zip code. At least few of the automation job openings, they will say automation design and automation framework design and implementation is must. Okay, is nothing but creating the automation scripts, automation framework, meaning creating the automation scripts in a much better format by following the better process. Okay, so by creating it is not like, okay, there is automation, Selenium automation framework, I will go and buy and use it. The simple example is, if you take your C drive, you're not putting everything under C drive, right? So if it is so you're arranging like in a different folders and all, because it is like a folder management, so that tomorrow you can find out where the exact document is located. So automation framework is nothing but a process, and we will write, I will give one a direct example. So when you join the company, there is a automation team already. They are not following the framework, they are just doing the regular automation. They are not following the framework means manual tester testing something, they will give their tests, you take it and automate, give it to them. The other company, there is automation team, but they are following the automation framework process. So they don't automate anything until they prepare the framework. Is nothing but they will create in Eclipse. They will create, see right now, under SRC, I put all the test cases, all the scripts. This is a non-automation framework approach. In the beginning, you will learn how to automate a particular test case. At the end, I will teach you how to prepare the automation framework. Let me show you this. So I'm not in rush. I have a lot of patience. My goal is you to learn properly and get a job and hold the job. Maybe you may get a job. I don't want you guys to fire after 2-3 weeks. Okay. So in US, there is a policy, right? 2 weeks or 1 month, you can use it. If you don't like it, you can return it. So 100% who are took training from me, they are who are we trained. They're all working peacefully at client's place. Give me a minute. Okay, if you see this, it is not like creating everything under SRC. We have different folder structure, we have different files in it. Okay, this is where we are writing the actual automation scripts. Okay, so we are arranging different folders within that. We are writing some common code. Let's take one more example. So we know Expedia.com, we can purchase a flight ticket, we can reschedule a flight ticket, we can cancel a flight ticket. So out of all three modules, if you see, if you want to purchase a flight ticket, you have to log in then purchase, log out. If you want to reschedule a flight ticket, you have to log in, then reschedule and log out. If you want to cancel a flight ticket, you have to log in, cancel and log out. Out of three, the common functions are login, logout. So in automation framework, when we have those common functions like login, logout, we will write, this is the base test. Some companies will call it as a common functions. This is where we will put. So we'll put all common functions here. So when we write purchase, reschedule, cancel, we'll simply call. But who are not following the framework approach and all, if you see their code, in purchase flight ticket, there is a login logout code. In reschedule and cancel also, there is a login logout code. So it's a duplication. So you will learn automation framework, how to design and implement with me peacefully. And as needed, you will use it in the company. So sometimes you may be the first automation engineer. It depends on time. You can decide whether to go with framework or without framework. But you should not put yourself in trouble. Okay. Next, we're also, I will make sure once we finish all six subjects, 200 to 205, you're going to have interview preparation, Selenium interview preparation session. So during that time, there is a bug here, right? It's a duplication. Selenium interview preparation. So during this time, FAQs and all, we are not only discussing in this class, every class we will discuss. And the Selenium interview preparation, what kind of questions they may ask. Tell me about yourself. Tell me about your latest automation project. Tell me about end-to-end automation process. What are the problems or challenges you face during your automation? Why Selenium? Why not other tool? There are so many questions may come. Sometimes they may test your patience. Let's say for Java, in order to do Selenium automation, just 20-30% of Java is good enough, but sometimes they may go for advanced level. Maybe they want to check where you are, or sometimes they want to check your patience levels. You should not say, the one student, this is what happened. They keep on asking advanced. That student was saying, if I know too advanced, why should I go for automation? I would have gone as a Java developer. Why are you asking so advanced? So you have to listen. If you know, you try to answer. Otherwise, you can say, let's say linked list is not really needed, or data structures is really not needed for Selenium automation. Sometimes they may ask. If you know, explain them. If you don't know, you can say, during my previous assignment with Selenium, I did not get a chance to work. But for this project, if it is needed, I'm a quick learner, I can learn it. So these are all the things will be discussed. And I'll help you on preparing Selenium resume. And once you finish everything, and if you say training is completed, your resume is ready, I reviewed and finalized, and also our H2K team will do the final review. And if you say I'm ready for the interviews, I can set up a mock interview with the students who took training and got a job and working as automation engineer. Okay, so that is all about this one. So total duration, for sure it will take 2+ months. We are going to have 3 classes per week, 1.5 hour each class, total 4.5 hours per week. Monday, Wednesday 9 p.m. to 10:30 p.m. EST, Saturday 11:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. EST. So this is what we are doing since couple of years. It's working out well, so that you will have a Monday you have a class, Tuesday you will get a chance to practice, Wednesday you have class, Thursday, Friday, you will get a chance to practice, and Saturday morning you can attend. So please let me know if anyone has any questions. I think this is the important slide. Are you hearing me? Shri, take us to ID. So Shri, we cannot hear you, but you're asking Selenium ID. So this is Selenium WebDriver code. But with the Selenium IDE, whatever test case I just showed, we can do the same by recording the script. Okay. But problem is, right now, whatever we did here, we wrote very little code, and all these keywords are coming from an Excel file. Let me show you that. Oh. So you the question can be in a, with the Selenium WebDriver we have to write code, but whereas Selenium IDE we can just record. So why do I need to, when record is there, why do I need to write a code? Why do I need to remember these commands, write a code, and waste my time? Why can't I just go for Selenium IDE? There are Selenium IDE, the problem is it will work only with the Firefox browser. Okay. And if you want Selenium IDE to work with other browsers, it never used to support. Maybe they recently added supporting other browsers, but another thing is not possible with the Selenium IDE is you cannot do data-driven test. Right now, whatever you have seen. Right now, whatever you have seen, okay. So there is an Excel file. Okay. This is the Excel file, right? This is where the Excel file is located. This is where we give the keywords. So basically, the entire script is data driven. That means in the Excel spreadsheet right now, we have 5 keywords. It will run for 5 times. If the Excel file manual tester can go and add some more keywords, let's say 200 keywords, you don't do any changes in the code. You will only modify the script, modify the keywords in the Excel spreadsheet. So manual tester can do it. Whereas if you automate the same using IDE, you have to ask manual tester to write additional, you have to ask a manual tester to add the additional recording. So that is kind of one example we can do, but definitely I will show you the difference, hands-on difference between IDE and WebDriver. Though you like it, I don't recommend. No one can hire you as an automation engineer using Selenium IDE. Okay, IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. Hope this is one of the example. So please let me know if anyone has any other questions. Otherwise, so what is automation testing? When and why and when to use automation? So we already discussed the difference between manual and automation. So that will automatically give this one. So benefits to the company, increase test coverage and reduce the risk. And we can deliver the products to the customers on time or early. So Selenium is open source tool. It's an automation tool for web applications. We can, using Selenium, we can run the scripts against IE, Firefox, Chrome, Safari. Basically, we can do cross-browser testing. Selenium is popular because it's open source free tool. And also, we can pick languages like Java, C Sharp, and all. So as part of our Selenium training, we are going to use Java because a lot of clients, they're asking Selenium with Java. So Selenium WebDriver is the actual tool you are doing. This is the architecture. We are going to discuss the architecture and all with a very detailed manner when we start Selenium next week. Selenium grid, we already discussed. Test engine, we already discussed. And automation framework, this is how the structure will be. So you will like it. Definitely. We are going to implement. This is a kind of the same way we implemented. So whatever you have seen here, and in Eclipse, I showed you right earlier the automation framework. So based on this, it was prepared. So this is not only for this is not only prepared for this demo. This is a kind of same template I'm presenting in my office. So we need to give as a QA automation manager or automation lead. So to the management, we have to give at the end. So how many projects we are automating? These four. So all these projects, the automation tool you can able to run. Yes, we have the automation for all four. Yes. So there is a different servers like QA staging, production. These are all manual testing topics. But when the time comes, I will even explain how many different environments. These are all like QA environment, staging, production, local automation environment and all. So we are telling the automation can run on project one on QA, staging, production, not local IE browser. We did not do it, for example. Firefox, why we are not doing in IE? Because this particular project not supporting IE browser. Okay. Like that, this is how the coverage we are presenting to the team or company. And they may ask, what are your short-term and long-term goals? Short-term goal is our any company, this is the first thing we have to do. We have to automate the smoke test cases, right? So smoke test case means a quick verification of the major functionality of the application. I will explain what is a smoke UAT. And once we automate them, then we will go for other test cases to automate. And also we may need to give the coverage, how much automation we completed so far. Maybe you no need to understand right away, but this is how you will present as a individual QA engineer. Also you may need to present to the team members how much it has been done. So Selenium demo I already gave, data-driven test for searching in Google. The same way, cross-browser testing by changing two lines of code. Right now I show how to do it in Firefox, but if I change two lines of code to Chrome, the same script will be executed on Chrome. And also if you change it back to IE, the same script will work on IE browser. So career opportunities, definitely long back we used to have Silk Test, Windrunner, QTP and all, but nowadays most of the companies migrated to Selenium. So there are plenty of opportunities there for you. So learn Selenium properly, apply for the jobs, you should be able to get it. So if you go to Monster, Dice and all these things, if you search for Selenium, this is how you will see your job openings. So if you go to Indeed.com, there you will even see how much salary you can get it. So this is what Concrete to Edge for H2K. So use syllabus and all, we are doing all these things. So you can see this in our website as well. So this is our company website URL. All this info, so our student coordinator also can provide you the info if you need more. So feedback, we can give it. Please let me know if anyone has any questions. It took more than expected time, but thanks for your patience. Ashri, we cannot able to hear you. Maybe next class, before even we start official class, I'll make sure each and everyone can see our desktop, can hear us, and also I'll make sure we can hear you. Both the sides will try. Maybe your speakers, maybe audio is not enabled on your system, I don't know, but for now I cannot hear you. We can type your question if we have. Okay, so anyone has any other questions before we stop this Selenium demo? We will share this Selenium demo recording. So feel free and contact our student coordinator And if you have any questions to me also, they can provide my email ID and phone number. You can do it. Otherwise, we'll meet next week, early next week, and we can officially start our first automation class. Shri, are you going to type your question? Okay, so I'm going to stop the recording.
This conference will now be recorded.
You can now type your questions here. We cannot hear you. So I'm going to stop the recording. Thanks a lot for attending today's Selenium training demo. Thanks for your patience. So we will share the Selenium training demo end of today or tomorrow. And if you have any questions about the registration, paying the fee and all, please contact our student coordinator. And they will tell you when is our first official class next week. And if you have any questions to me, take the email ID or phone number from them, and they will, we can talk and I can explain. Sindhu has a question, for the entry-level Selenium job, do they expect to have manual QA experience? So manual, for automation engineers, manual testing, definitely you need to know. So basically either your entry-level automation engineer or senior level automation engineer, you need to work with the manual testing team. That means you need to know what manual tester is doing, at least high level. What is your interaction with manual testing team? That is what I'm going to cover as part of our end-to-end automation testing process. So don't worry about it. We are going to cover that. Okay, Sindhu, you got it? So that's why the first item I told, for automation testing, the prerequisites is manual testing. I'm going to cover how much manual testing is needed for automation engineers as part of our end-to-end automation process. Okay, that's all for today. Have a good night. See you everyone next week. Bye for now.